Hey guys. Today for the review, we have the Gochifix LG304. We received this product from the Gochifix company to make a review. It's the Gochifix 3-in-1 Digital Oscilloscope Multimeter LG304. This device operates as a multimeter and an oscilloscope, setting it apart from many devices designed to function solely as one or the other. This oscilloscope has a 2-channel and 1 ground ports. The dual-channel oscilloscope enables the capture of 2 distinct signals, such as signals from separate circuits or components. First, we'll open the box and evaluate its features. The oscilloscope multimeter is available through the link provided in the video description. The box includes an alligator clip probe, 2 probe leads, the oscilloscope multimeter with a portable bag, a high voltage probe set, a Type-C cable, an operation instruction diagram, and a user manual. Unlike other multimeters that use batteries, this one self-charges using a Type-C cable. On the back of the multimeter, there is a kickstand which allows for easy viewing of the display. This multimeter has 2 probes. The red probe typically connects to the positive terminal, while the black probe is intended for the negative terminal. Connect the black probe to the COM port. Connect the red probe to the voltage resistance port. Press the power button to turn on the multimeter. The screen features a 2.8-inch color display that is very clear. Now we'll showcase this product by conducting a series of tests, beginning with a voltage check on a battery. I have a AA battery. It should show a reading of 1.5 volts if it's still good. Touch the black probe lead on the battery's negative terminal, and the red probe lead on the positive terminal. The reading shows around 1.5 volts, indicating that the battery is good. If you reverse the leads, you should get the same number, but it will be negative. The following test involves measuring the resistance of this resistor. This is a 2000 ohms resistor. On the multimeter, press the resistance diode button to switch to the resistance setting. It has the ohms symbol. Touch the probe leads on each end of the resistor. The reading is around 2000 ohms. This is what we expected. The next test is to verify continuity. I have an alligator clip for this test. If the alligator clip is good, we should have continuity. Press the F3 button to toggle to the continuity setting. Touch the probe leads on each end of the alligator clip. We hear a beep. That means the alligator clip is good since we have continuity. Now let's switch to using the oscilloscope. Insert the connector of the high voltage probe into channel 1. Take out the kickstand on the back of the oscilloscope. Hold the power button for 2 seconds to turn it on. Press the CH1 button to toggle to the oscilloscope mode. We have a power cord connected to an outlet. Attach the ground lead to one end of the wire. Attach the probe tip to the other end of the wire. Press the auto button to set the vertical and horizontal amplitude automatically. you get stable periodic signals using the automatic setting. You can adjust the waveform by pressing the arrow keys. If there is a waveform you want to see for later viewing, you can save it by pressing the Save button. To view the saved waveforms, press the Menu button. When waveform is selected, press the Enter button. Use the arrow keys to select the waveform you want to view. Press the Enter button to view it. This is a good product, combining a multimeter and an oscilloscope into a single package. Its interface is straightforward and user-friendly. I like the user manual. It covers the essentials and helps you get started quickly. The oscilloscope multimeter is available through the link provided in the video description. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.